And last but not least, Emma, we're going to take you to the place where I met the coolest lady. She was very old. It was in a town called, and I'm going to watch my enunciation, Chitwood. Chit. C-H-I-T-W-O-O-D. It's a covered bridge from Corvallis on the way to, from Corvallis to Walport.
Okay.
We stopped by. One little old lady lives there, and I tell you what, she was the most charming, beautiful, amazing lady. And so we're going to end by showing you the story of this wonderful little lady in Chitwood.
I'm always going to let you handle that name, because I am going to get us in some trouble. Sounds good.
You've probably driven by the old red covered bridge at Chitwood when you're driving from Corvallis to Newport. It'd be an important spot on the railroad. If you read the sign, it was 139 8/10 of a mile to Portland and 750 6/10 of a mile to San Francisco. But today, this is what's left of old Chitwood. This is a story of a place called Chitwood, a spot on the side of the road that meanders through the hills of Corvallis and drops you off in Newport.
Chitwood is always Chitwood, and it's alive for me.
That's Maud Eastwood. She's 88 years old. Maud has outlasted just about everything in Chitwood. She's even 6 years older than that old red-covered bridge. Maud was one of 11 children. Her daddy used to run the town's market and post office. She grew up in this old house that sat on the same property as her current home. The old house didn't last. The memories do.
What we would do on Saturday nights, there'd be a big bonfire of ties that they'd taken off, you know, that need to be burned up. The whole community would meet. They were Norwegians, it would be pleb kind of instrument. But you see, we were all so pure that we weren't allowed to open up the window where we were sleeping and hear the music. But they had fights and everything, you know.
Somehow you heard it.
Well, I snuck it open when they were.
They didn't go to the town church. Her daddy didn't like the denomination, so they had church at home.
When it was time for us to be baptized, why, we were baptized under the bridge down here, of course.
Chitwood was a fuel stop. Backs were powered with wood. Folks in Chitwood cut cord after cord to load on the trains as it made its way back and forth to the coast. When the highway came in, Chitwood's doom was sealed. Folks stayed busy for a while. Maud and most of her friends moved away. A few years ago, she and her husband came back. He later died. At one time, there were 30 families in these parts. Now it's just Maud, a couple of neighbors, a sheep or two, the bridge, and her hill.
That's what's keeping me living, is going up and down that hill. Like I said, I've got air in my lungs now. I've got muscles in my legs. I beat the United Parcel Man up.
In Maud's mind, Chitwood has always been home.
When I was a pre-teenager, the night, the stars, the outside, it was something, it was part of me. To hear the wind in the leaves, it was part of me.
How does one put into words a lifetime of memories that somehow seemed to come back to such a place?
It was if I had left when I came back, it was as if it was all still here for me.
There's something about childhood. It grips us. It won't let us go. Home.
And I thought, God is good. Here's where I'm supposed to be. He has seen to it that I'm back again. And I'm looking at that same moon going over the sky.
Home doesn't have to be where you live.
So you're back home.
I'm back home.
Chitwood. It did matter. More than a bridge, you bet. Just think what you'd miss if you didn't stop and ask a few questions.